massacre. You don't even know me, but every time I see you, you say, Alleyway massacre. Alleyway massacre. You don't even know me, but every time I see you, you say, Alleyway massacre. Alleyway massacre. Hey, what's up, everybody? Hope you all are doing all right. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's greatly appreciated. Firstly, sorry that I didn't do a live stream last night. I was just at a braai, and I caught up with some friends that I haven't seen in a very long time. And it was very lacquered to catch up with those individuals. So, sorry. Sorry, not sorry, if that makes sense. I hope that you all have had a lacquer Friday. Anything interesting that happened, anything interesting happening tonight or that happened today? Super Mace, the Handy Fixer, Q, Bella Blue, Michiel, Carl, Alan, Kotze, and Grant. How's it going? Thank you for tuning in. I know that I set this live stream for 7:30, but we went to Paradise Beach earlier today. It's close to Jeffreys Bay for those of you that might not know. And then we got home earlier, but I realized that it was load shedding. And if I was going to do that stream, then I would either have to put the generator off 30 minutes later, or I would have to cut the stream and start it again. So yeah. James says, how are you, sir? Ever played chess? I tried, but I can't play chess. I can play it basically. Like I know all the moves. I know kind of how to look one step ahead for the player that you're playing against, but I could never ever wrap my head around how to get checkmate. I could never do that. So I'm definitely not. I'm not good. I haven't played it in many years. I've played it on the most basic level against a computer, and then I would win, but it would take me like, I don't know, 40 extra moves. So I just don't have that foresight in chess to predict the moves. But tic-tac-toe, I can beat anybody in tic-tac-toe. Tic-tac-toe, I'm untouchable. I haven't lost, I think, in the last 10 years. Not that I've played it every day or even once a month, but I'm untouchable with tic-tac-toe. Okay. Grant says, it looks like I will have to send you my details again. I've sent it like a month ago. I know you're busy. But if that is an understatement, so please do send it again. But realize that at the moment, like even my weekend, like today, I've received about 40 WhatsApps. And then on top of that, we had a conference to deal with constitutional matters within the Federal Congress that's coming up. We had 100 items today. So whilst I was driving, I had to listen. Whilst we were at Lauren's parents' house, I had to listen and form part of a discussion with regards to that. So I'm sorry. That's all I can say. I mean, the sign in the back, I'm sorry. The new Zach merch, I'm sorry. It's just with the load shedding outages, with the water crisis in Nelson Mandela Bay, it's just, it's crazy. Why Julia says, hello everybody, I thought this was at 7:30. Yeah, I had to start it early because load shedding ends at 8 p.m. Which means that I would either have had to run an extra 30 minutes on the generator, or I would have only had a 30-minute stream. So yeah. Faye says, hello, how's it, Faye? Hope you're doing alright. I haven't seen you in a while. Really. How's it, Mel? Michiel says, what's schedule? Just actually tired. I'm just a little bit lazy. Like that one over there. What you doing, boy? Yo, they've been so itchy. And we've now bought them like oil to drink, to work from the inside out to their skin. We've got the shampoo that you leave on them for 15 minutes. So you bath them and then you scrub this onto the skin and wait 15 minutes. Now imagine having to have a dog in the bath with nothing happening for 15 minutes. And it's just not going away. It's just, I'm actually thinking that it's now, it is a heat issue because their temperatures run very high. So yeah. Michiel says, Ronaldo, even me, ek het eers 1 uur vanmiddag wakker geword. Yo, if I had to wake up at that time now, I would like cry. From like, I mean, that is the time I used to wake up when I used to DJ, but then again, I went to bed at like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. So my clock just worked around that time. But yeah, I mean, if I had to wake up that time now, I would like consider it like a completely lost day. I mean, I have so little time. I have to enjoy every moment I can of the weekend. But like as Murphy's Law would have it, during the week, I struggle to wake up. Like I really wish I had another hour, and then I turn and I literally have to sit up while I'm half asleep just to not fall asleep again. But on weekends, on like this morning, I went to bed at 1 o'clock and I woke up at 6 o'clock. And then I had to force myself to sleep. I had to leapele, because that works. If I leapele with Lauren, then I could fall asleep again. So I had to do that. Have you seen the new Jason Statham movie? No. What's it called? Why Zulu says consult your vet. It could be serious. We have. That is what we did, and that is what the vet recommended. I think it's time to switch vets. Like, listen. Like, look at them. My boy. You want to show? No, I'm not going to show the people. Shame. He's got like red marks underneath here from scratching. He even scratched his like the side of his nose open where the hair is missing. It's ridiculous. Hey, stop it now, my boy. I know. Look at him. Come here. You want to say hello to everybody? Come. Whenever you're ready. He's doing this bunny hop thing now. Come, jump. Thank you. Like, he looks fine, yeah, but, like, let me see if I can do this. Look at this. Look how red his chest is, right? And then look there. You see these marks there? Look how red he is. And then, yeah, if you look at his face on... Hey, are you not going to be difficult? Yeah, of course he will. I mean, why would he want to show that side of his face now? Look at that. You see that mark there? You can see it there. That's like there's no hair left. Oh, my boy. I'm so sorry. And he's so hot. He's like running insanely hot. So the only thing that I can think is that he needs, like, we need something to cool them down. Ree says, hey, beautiful people. I wear an older lekker in die Kaap. Lekker. Woe, is julle in die Kaap? Wat maak julle daar, Ree? Dit klink lekker. He must be allergic to fleas. Well, it's Kenny and Carter. So, and at first we thought it was perhaps those red little ticks at the park. So we didn't take them to the park for 2 weeks and it just got worse. You call that a hot dog. Yeah. Kan heat rush wees. Die Boston Terrier like nie die heat nie. Ja, dis ook waar. But I mean, it has never been this bad. And they like 5 and 6 years old. So, yeah. Ree says, ja, my jaarlikse keier by my familie. Wel, dit klink lieflik, Ree. Geniet Jannie dit daarom. Is Jannie saam met jou? As Jannie nie saam met jou is, nie is al groot kak. Egskeiding, probleme daar. What have I missed? Why Julie says, I'm a veterinary nurse and I suggest you get a second opinion. Yeah, we're definitely going to do that. Zypher says, hey Ronaldo, how has your weekend been? Do you have any update on the VIT situation? Nothing, but I see that they started their cock at UCT now. UCT. Like, these are future leaders and future professionals in South Africa. Like, UCT burnt tires in a circle, stood around it and kind of sounded like they were singing Kumbaya because they wanted to get their historical debt eradicated. Now imagine, like, after 3 years of studying, you go, hey, you know what, thank you for this degree, I'm not gonna pay you for it, and if you dare ask me to settle my student debt, I'm going to protest and burn tires. Like, how fucking special must you be? Especially, you know, you expect this from like grade 10, grade 6, grade 3 pupils. You don't expect this from people that are catching their degrees. They should rather stop catching feelings and start catching degrees. That's quite clever. Michiel says, Ronaldo, logic, na, what? Logic net, dis hoekom ek nie meer daar is nie. Dit spil so hard oor in corporate. That's the thing. That's why we've got this woke sickness in South Africa at the moment, where everybody is offended about everything. You know, and this is the thing. The wokies on TikTok are offended when people don't say him or her, well, when they don't say they, them, right? They lose their shit there. Bianca on TikTok is constantly lecturing people about apartheid, but you don't hear fuck all from them with regards to this. You don't hear anything about the student protests. You don't hear anything about Julius Malema and the EFF threatening to bring this country to a standstill. You don't hear that shit. You don't hear about Pala Pala. You don't hear about Cyril Ramaphosa's absolute failure with his ministerial positions. No. What Bianca will talk about day and night is about apartheid, something that ended 30 years ago. She will continue to talk about that and try and portray that as the reason why South Africa is in the state it's in. But she will not say a fucking thing about the current state of South Africa. No, she will not. She will not talk about the failures right now by people that are wealthy, that are powerful and influential. She will not talk about that. And the woke people on TikTok won't talk about that. And I suspect that is why I'm doing so well on TikTok at the moment. Like knock on wood, I can't put a foot wrong on TikTok. At the moment, like, every video I make hits like 30,000 views. And yeah, we know it's not going to last long. We know it's going to be only a matter of time before something gets mass reported. And then I'm banned for 3 days again. But hey, I'm riding the wave at the moment. And like, I've jumped up by like 9,000 subscribers in like, I don't know, 10 days. It's like almost 1,000 subscribers a day. So long may it last, but yeah, I highly doubt that it's going to last that long. White Zulu says, have you discussed the manhandling of those thugs of a white woman doctor in a hospital? I have not spoken about it because I don't really have a lot of insight and I can't really find a lot of information. So, I mean, I can make a video and say, hey, look at how they're manhandling this female doctor or nurse or whatever she is. Like, I mean, like, it's not adding any value. It's really not adding. So, I mean, I've seen the video and it's horrendous. And, you know, it's so close to when we had International Women's Day. And then you have people like this treating a female like that. It's just, it's atrocious, man. Debbie says it's eczema. Just like humans, an allergic reaction when exposed to allergens that are either absorbed through the skin or inhaled. Homeopaths have brilliant cures. I will tell Lauren that, but I know that we have, that the vet have given both of them an injection that was supposed to ease this for like a month, and it didn't do anything. It didn't do anything. So we're at that point now where, like, I mean, I don't mind spending money on them. Like, I mean, they're my children. You know, I'll sell my car in order to make sure that they feel better. But I don't know, we need to go and see another vet. I mean, the vet that we used to see moved to New Zealand and then they got replaced. And we thought at first that, you know, the new vet was good because, I mean, they assist with one or two issues. But I mean, yeah, it's, I mean, if you can't after two consultations tell me why my dog is fucking itching, I think you need to go back and perhaps study some more, because I'm paying you top dollar to tell me why my two dogs are itching. I mean, I didn't study it, but I'm pretty sure it's not rocket science. So I don't have a fucking clue. I'm paying you to tell me what the problem is. And after two consultations and injecting them and letting me buy the most expensive fucking shampoo I've ever seen in my life and giving them this oil that you have to squirt into their mouths, like 6 moles of it, like nothing. Ricky Lowe says, hello from Perth. How's it? Fancy seeing you in Australia, mate. Yeah. Mel says, YouTube advertising you. I'm getting suggestions of some of your YouTubes from 5 to 9 years ago. Hey! Thanks, YouTube. Thank you for sharing current events. I suppose in South Africa, 5 years ago, videos are still relevant now more than ever. So yeah. Have you been contacted in the past by individuals because of videos which you've made on topics which you have spoken about? And has that ever put you off of discussing certain topics? I've been, like, a lot of my videos from back in the day is now taken out of context and used against me. And thank God, many, many years ago, I removed a lot of videos that would now just be considered completely inappropriate according to the woke culture that we live in. Because I can either, a lot of people have called me out and said, why did you remove it? You just gave in. No, I actually removed those videos before this whole woke bullshit started. It's because my opinion changed on a lot of things. And although I still feel passionately about it, the way that I put the message across was just too bad. And I know that my swearing has increased drastically again. It's not on the levels that it used to be when I was Rendir. But I think all of us are frustrated. This constant load shedding in Nelson Mandela Bay, the drought, the incompetence, and everything just becoming more and more expensive is really riling me up the wrong way, and it's bringing out that inner Rendir that clearly I thought, that Rendir got classier. No, clearly not. And I know it's weird speaking about myself in the third person, but yeah, it's just... I have a lot of people that try and twist those videos from back in the day, but anybody with two brain cells or more can see that those videos are either doctored or it's completely taken out of context. The one favorite that they like to use is me apparently, using a gay slur, which was doctored. You just need to go and look at my history from many years ago, even before that video that they've doctored, in which I proudly promote, gay rights, where I speak up for the gay community, the LGBTQI+ community. And I mean, I've DJed at so many events, pride events. I've helped assisted pride events from continuing, why would, the whole notion of, I don't know what in my day-to-day make people believe that I'm anti-gay. I mean, I'm not going to go into that, my best friend is gay, but, if I had to go into detail, who my friends are, what social events I attend, what I've done to assist, etc., it'll make those people look like idiots. So, yeah. But I just try and actually just not give it any attention anymore. Like I did when those videos started coming out. But you can so clearly see that it's doctored now by today's standards that it's like, it's not even worth me responding to those videos. I know that Bianca loves to share those videos on her TikTok to try and discredit me. She knows that it's bullshit. She knows that it's fake. But she just consistently shares it because she's still upset that I completely annihilated her in our debate a couple of years ago. Afroan says, oe, en ek mod ook nie meer nie. No, okay, let me tell you what happened. So, I'm assuming that you can see that Streamlabs is back. Did any of you notice that? Streamlabs is back. So, Afroan, what I actually was trying to do is I was trying to... Here we go. This is what I wanted to do. But I couldn't do it. So, I removed you as a moderator because I wanted to make you the managing moderator. So I wanted to make you and Mel S the managing moderators, which I'm going to do now. But why? Okay, well, I can only do one, so I'll switch it around. Alpha One, you are the managing moderator right now. I thought that I could do more than one. But I brought back Streamlabs and I corrected the point system. I removed 3 zeros off of everybody's points because I believe that is what the problem was. Or actually 4 zeros. Because I know that Reese's... Reese's husband was the one with the most points. So then I fixed that, obviously. Yanni, I mean, I'm sorry, I don't know why I said Reese's husband. It's just Yanni. Yanni had the most points. Oh, so I kry a promotion. Ja, maar vir fokol reis. Jy kry niks extra geld hê. Mal says, I saw Streamlabs back, but too scared to try. Yeah, what I tried to do is, let me tell you what I tried to do. So, I want to start multi-streaming. I want to start streaming to Facebook, to YouTube, and to TikTok at the same time. So what happened was I signed up for Streamlabs Ultra, which is, I think, yeah, what was it, 150 Rand a month. I think 250 Rand a month. But then you can go and set it up so that you can multi-stream. However, after I did it, like, then they said, oh, if you have a Mac, you can't do this with TikTok. You can only add it if you have Windows. I mean, this is something they should have fucking warned you about when you, because I've got Streamlabs for Mac, you know, and I signed up for Streamlabs Ultra for Mac, and they still advertise TikTok on there. So then after that, I just said, no, fuck it, I want a refund. Like, bullshit, I'm not going to do that. But in the process, when I had to set up the Ultra stuff, I said, well, let me fix the Streamlabs stuff, and let me also fix the point things. So let me know the points, and let me know if it is accurate. I'm assuming it's accurate. There was, I think, 11, 12, or 13 people that had abnormal points. And I'm not talking about people that really do give a lot of super chats. I'm talking about, it was just an absurd amount. Like, I would have to pretty much hand over my house to Reese and to Yanni, which obviously I don't want to do. Because then I don't have any place to live. I mean, I wouldn't mind to move in with Reese and Yanni. They've got a lovely house. But yeah. Jack Boeta says, I have a billion points. Well, you see, that's problematic. I don't think you do, though. Can somebody just run the top points and let's just see what the top points are? I mean, it should be more in line. And please also just note that a lot of these things that are still gifts, I don't have anymore. Like, let's check here. An apron, I don't have anymore. So yeah. Top points. Yanni has got 72,306. You see, that's more realistic, because it means he can get two hoodies if he wanted to. So I think those points are realistic. I mean, that is what I looked at, considering how much you get for a super chat, and yeah. Mm-hmm. The good stuff. Anyway, tell me what's news, everybody. What's crack-a-lacking? How are you guys doing? What are your plans for the evening? I want to, after the load shedding ends, I'm going to watch the Christoph Waltz's new series. What is it called? It's not called The Accountant. It's called something like that. Somebody in the chat will tell me now. I started watching Arcane. That's good. I saw that they released another kind of couple of episodes of Attack on Titan. I want to watch that. What are your thoughts on Louis Liebenberg? What happened? And which Louis Liebenberg? Mel says it seems to be correct. Thanks, Mel. Alpha One says ek is daarom nog top 10. Ja, met al die 7 randjies wat jy een keer 'n jaar gee, ek weet nie hoe jy dit reg kry nie. Jy praat net baie, want jy kry punte as jy baie praat ook. So ja. Did you guys see that the public protector didn't find any fault with Paula Paula? I mean, if there was ever any doubt how incompetent the public protector is, I mean, her scope was so narrow. It's just, well, ethically, if the president overstepped in his role. I mean, why even publish shit like that? I mean, that is not, nobody is actually interested in that aspect of it. The interesting point here is, how the fuck did 11.5 million rand end up in his couch? And why is there no SARS record of that transaction? That is what everybody wants to know. Not whether or not ethically, you know, doing business as a president and having a farm that trades in fuck, I don't know, whatever, whether that is legit or not. I mean, it just once again shows that this public protector, and look, I'm not a fan of Thuli Maroncela. I'm not a fan of her. She is way too socialist and communist. But I mean, it's just like, how much more evidence do you need that this person is so incompetent and so in the pocket of the ANC? It's like insane. Debbie says Borton paid for that finding for sure. Yeah. It's ridiculous. I mean, name one minister or ANC MP or MPL that's worth their salt. And if you can't even mention one or two or three, then it just shows in what deep shit we are in this country. Nicholas says, are you really surprised that Cyril got a free pass? As long as the ANC is in power, nobody in their party will see justice. No, I'm not really surprised. It's, you know, it's like a mixture of disappointment and just like, how the fuck do they think they can get away with this? That is it. It's like, how do they think they're going to get away? Like, it's the same with the mayor of Tshwane. Well, the former mayor of Tshwane. Like, corruption in this country has become so obvious and so in your face that this guy actually believed. And he's a doctor. Now, look, we need to question that now, too. I mean, you know, everything in his life is now going to be questioned. And rightfully so. Because he's a piece of shit for what he did. He's a piece of shit for misleading people, forging a document. He's a criminal. He's a criminal. And this is the person that they wanted to become mayor of Tshwane. How in your right mind, with all that heat on you, and with all that pressure, and knowing that whatever document you're going to be supplying is going to be scrutinized, do you still supply a forged document? I mean, it clearly shows that firstly, you've got fuck all common sense. Secondly, it shows that you're an absolute idiot. And thirdly, it just once again shows that you can study, you can get all the degrees behind your name, you can be called a doctor, but as you're fucking dumb, as you're dumb. And I is fucking dumb. I believe the courts and judges have been bought, says Wadzulu. I don't believe that to that extent. I believe that there might be corrupt judges, as is the case anywhere around the world. I still believe that our justice system is relatively untouched by the politicians. But I do think that there is a clear bias. I do think that there is a bias, especially if you look at like the struggle songs. And it's not necessarily for or against the ANC or for or against the EFF, but it's definitely leaning towards more of a cultural shift towards what is considered acceptable. Like a struggle song, like Kill the Boer was a struggle song. Nobody denies that. But do we really need to sing a song like that in 2023? No, you don't. But the courts and the judges seem to think, oh, you know, technically it's a struggle song. Technically, there's nothing wrong with it. Take the fucking technically out of it and look at the lyrics. Kill the Boer, kill the farmer. How is that conducive to building a nation? Like, sometimes the courts just, like, they get involved so much in the legal mumbo-jumbo bullshit of it, and they're not just thinking of it as a human being, you know? Like, imagine all these young white children hearing a song like that being sung. Is that not going to influence them? Isn't that going to bring questionable characteristics that they might develop because of that shit? And the same on the black child side. They get taught that this is fine to sing. So as a child, they innocent, but then they go to the rallies with their parents and they hear, pa, 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 pa. They hear that, like mimic gunshot noises, and they hear kiss the boer and then it's kill the boer whenever they feel like it. And then you go, children are hearing this, and apparently it's right because it's all over media, and the judges say, there's nothing wrong with it. You know, like, is this really the message that we want to send to our children 30 years after we've become a democracy? That there is more racial hatred now than the first 5 years after, like, 1994. Jan van Riebeek says, ek het no ontdekt if kanaal. Wel, welkom Jan, jy is 368 of something years late. Welcome Jan. Welkom jou poesen. Kat. Remember, he's speaking Dutch. It's not a swear word. It's not a swear word. Don't get happy. I'm sure Jan liked a lot of poes back in the day. Katte, of course. Arbot says, judges are biased AF, Ronaldo. That's why I'm against the death penalty. Yeah, in a perfect world, you know, people will be punished for the sins that they commit. Yo, Streamlabs. Support my channel by giving a super chat, Zapper, SnapScan, or PayPal. It's like, okay. I think we get it. And yes, I'm the one that wrote that. Leonard Rasmus says, Jan van Riebeek is not even known in the Netherlands. Well, I mean, it's because he was... Wasn't he banished from the Netherlands? I mean, I'm sure if you had to ask, you know, do you realize the Dutch discovered South Africa? Well, not discovered. Sorry, before I get cancelled. The Dutch arrived in South Africa. You know, I'm pretty sure they would know that that happened. And I'm pretty sure that they are also aware that Jan van Riebeek was the first Dutch individual to arrive in South Africa. On his skip. Die grote skier. Anyway. Everybody is just so relaxed. And you guys are all looking at me expecting me to just, like, create some entertainment here. Mel says it also depends if the judges want to move up in the ranks. Well, I mean, yeah. I've heard some horror stories from a certain advocate that I won't really mention here. Leanne says the problem is how desensitized we are. Because I, for one, am not surprised that another corrupt individual got off scot-free. That's the thing. It's the moral standard in this country has gone down the drain. Mel says, you've spoiled us, Ronaldo. Yeah, but I'm a little bit tired. I'm doing this new thing where I'm taking a break from the edibles over the weekend. And then I just take like a small dosage of sleeping pills. Sleeping pill. Let me not create the wrong impression here. Because as much as I microdose on edibles, you also need a break. It's not it's not good to do something consistently non-stop. So, Bartolomeas Diaz discovered South Africa, Mosselbaai, and sold the maps to Europeans. That is why I said he was the first Dutch individual to arrive and discovered South Africa. I specifically said Dutch. Rewind. And that is why Jan van Riebeek discovered South Africa. Oh, wait, before I get cancelled. He was the first Dutch person to arrive in South Africa. You see, that's what I said. I think that was good. Yeah, I'm on an edible break myself, lol. Okay. Diaz was Portuguese. Yeah, I know he was. I'm fully aware. Bartolomeas Diaz, he's got that statue with the cross. Fully aware. I know my history. Jan van Riebeek says, Ronaldo, slaappillen zijn gevaarlijk. Ek verstaan. Ek verstaan. Dit is gevaarlijk. Jan, ek het 'n vraag vir jou. Kit. Debbie says, same. That's why I just picked up Dominoct to aid good sleep. If there's a pill that works, I'll take it. Thanks. I agree. You know, if I want to relax, I mean, I work so hard, and I'm not trying to sell it to you. I'm trying to just convince you that sometimes taking a pill is not the worst thing in the world, especially if you're having trouble like relaxing or you're having trouble just calming down and taking it easy. Sometimes you need an aid. I mean, my brain, I always have to do two things at the same time. I can't just sit and watch a movie. I have to watch a movie and be on my laptop or on my phone. Even when I do this, you know, I've got the screen open. Sometimes I want to show you guys something. So even when I'm in my car, I listen to an audiobook. When I fall asleep at night, I fall asleep listening to an audiobook. So, yeah. By the way, Jan, yeah, you are, but this is not you. And I also don't know why you would use the fake Jan van Riebeek. This is not the real Jan van Riebeek. This is an imposter. This is an imposter. You want to know what the real Jan van Riebeek looked like? Let me show you. This is what the real Jan van Riebeek looked like. There he is. That's the real Jan van Riebeek. Hy lyk asof hy 'n paar choppies te veel gehad het, maar hy kennetjie van hom, hè? Ja, jy moes maar 'n baard gegroei het om hy dubbel kennetjie van jou weg te steek. Hy lyk of hy 'n paar king pies te veel gehad het, jy weet. Hy love hy peppersteak king pie 'n bietjie te veel, soos jy kan sien. Ek meen, they when they paint you, they try and hide you know, your shortcomings. Like over here, I mean, they had to probably tone this down a bit, so I'm pretty sure this was a little bit more. So yeah, I mean, for those of you that don't know, Jan van Riebeek brought king pie to South Africa. Oh fuck, oh, this kak praat die siekte was, soos ek al lank al. Op die R5 noot het daai man hare op jaloer. Wat het daai man hare om op jaloers te wees? I know, it's the Gucci Jan. It's the Gucci Jan. He even has a snor that most people can be proud of. But I mean, how, like, what a fuck up, by the way. Like, this is what the apartheid government put on their currency. And they put on not even the real Jan van Riebeek. I mean, I'm assuming this is why so many people believe that this is the real Jan. It's because of the apartheid government not even knowing their history and not even accurately depicting the real Jan van Riebeek. But then again, I'm assuming we're also harshly judging. Oh, okay, let me rephrase. Fuck, I need to be very careful with my words now. The apartheid government was evil, they were cancerous, and they were atrocious, right? But what I'm trying to say is, back then there wasn't internet, you know, you couldn't just go quickly do a Google search to say, hey, is this a real Jan? You know, like, you had to go with whatever books they had, and perhaps in three books that they researched, that was the Jan that they saw, and then they decided, okay, well, this must be the real Jan. But then after the fact, many years later, when we started having internet and all of that shit, they actually like communicated with the Dutch and said, hey, well, you know, what did Jan van Riebeek look like? We would like to get more information on this guy. And then they went, that is Jan. And they're like, nee, this is Jan. And they go, nee, that is Gucci Jan. This is the real Jan. And you're like, ooh, fuck. Okay, ons het opgefok, manne. Ons het opgefok. Anyway, Arbot says Photoshop. Carly Green says, my crippling anxiety doesn't allow sleep too often, so any aid will do. Yeah, I hear you. Listen, Carly, if I can give you a tip, though. Edibles has a longer lasting effect than just the initial high that it gives you. The half-life of edibles and weed specifically the calming weed, I can't remember if it's a sativa or the indica. I think it's the indica. Or no, I'm just saying it indica, that's how you pronounce it. I think the sativa one is the one that calms you down. So if I can give you a tip, I would say try, you know, a jelly or, but, you know, be very careful with your dosage. And then just check, because since I started taking edibles, my anxiety has completely disappeared. And I'm talking about the next day. I take my edibles at, I used to take it at 7 o'clock, and then at the end of the stream, people could see I was kind of getting high. So I moved it by an hour. So I take my edibles at 8 p.m., kicks in at 9, and then I sleep like during, and I don't wake up with that crippling anxiety of, did I miss 100 calls? Did I miss like 40 WhatsApp messages? I wake up honestly not caring, because it's like, they can wait. They can wait for me. And I have to say, like, usually, you know, driving in a car would cause an like anxious situation. Knowing that I've got a meeting where I have to speak to like 200-300 people, all of that shit's gone out the window. Completely gone out the window. So try an edible. Just try it. But be careful with the dosage. Like, if you're gonna go for the, and don't just get a lolly from a friend or something from a friend that you don't know what the dosage is and all that shit, please, because that is the quickest way to cause you to automatically get into a panic attack when you start getting high, because you're like, is this ever gonna end? And you can actually feel the earth like moving, you know, and there's nothing worse, than taking too much, and you know that for the next 4 hours, you're not getting out of that shit any way, shape, or form. You just have to ride that wave. There's nothing worse than that. Kray means in with your slimmer mark. Well, the one that gives you a lot of energy apparently makes you like get your jobs done quicker and more efficiently. So, yeah, I'm assuming so. I had too much my first time and I just slept through it. Yeah. My second time, I had too much because I started getting brave, and yo, I had a panic attack whilst being high. But I mean, it was the most relaxed panic attack ever, if that makes sense. I was like sitting there going, oh, I'm having a panic attack. My heart's racing. I'm sweating. But I don't really give a fuck. It was so weird. Debbie says, Google, loads of places depending on your area. Mary Jane. Exactly. Let me just give you an example. So, this is a good example. Sweet Jane. It's sealed. You know it's good. And at the back, it says there, 100 milligrams. Now, if you take this when you just start, you're not going to have a good time. You're going to feel the earth rotation. You're going to, your head's going to spin. It's not going to be fun. I promise you, it's not going to be fun. But if you take like 12 and a half milligrams for your first time, you're going to be A-okay. I promise you. It's going to feel like, you know, the closest thing that I can associate it with, it's like imagine you're at a braai with a bunch of like friends, and you guys have had just enough beer where you don't have to go to the toilet. But you're feeling that buzz, you know, that lack of buzz, and it's a Saturday, you've got nothing to do tomorrow, and, you know, you're just having a good time. That's what it feels like. That's what it feels like when you just have an edible and the right dosage. It's just like that lekker. It's lekker om te leven. That's exactly what it feels like. Where do you buy it in PE? I buy my stuff at the Pottery. In Warmer in Port Elizabeth. You have to, obviously you have to register to become a member, and you have to answer questions, and you have to legitimately sign up and get a card. It's like medicinal, because I mean, I can prove that I had anxiety, almost borderline depression, so I can prove that I'm using it for medicinal purposes. What a unique name. Love it. What, Mary Jane? That's cool. On the back it says not for sale. Well, it isn't for sale. As a member, Well, I'm assuming it's not for sale to the general public. You have to sign up as a member, pay your membership, and you go from there. Arbot says that sounds more like a hospital case. Don't be a typical stubborn man. You need a rhizotomy procedure. What are you talking about? Okay, you guys are talking some deep shit there. What happened to Arbot? I'll rest when I'm dead, Debbie. My torn ligaments in my back, and I might have slipped a disc. I'm in full spasm at the moment. Four physio sessions and a ton of meds and injections. You need to get to the hospital, bud. I know it sucks. I know it is. It's not like a. You don't fuck with your back. You're probably gonna have to go and get an operation where they put you in those metal braces in the back. And I know it sucks, but for 6 weeks you won't be able to sit. You're gonna probably have to lie or stand. Those are your only two options. But would you rather have that than this pain that you're experiencing right now? I mean, there's two things that I really ever. I mean, I've already had kidney stones, so I can't say kidney stones, but I did fear having kidney stones. And I lived through it. It was bad, but it was manageable. You know, it's like it is the worst pain I've ever experienced, but it was still manageable with medication. Without medication, it felt like I was going to die. But there's two things that I do not want. Let's make it three things, right? I never ever want to break my kneecap, right? I never ever want to break my kneecap. Second thing is, I never ever want to injure my back or my spine to the point where I have to go for the operation that you might have to go for. And then I don't know, the third thing is, I don't ever 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 want to be. I mean, I've experienced the flicks of your testicle, bumping your testicle against something. I never ever want to get a cricket ball or a tennis ball or being kicked in the balls. I never want to experience that pain. Never. Because, like, I mean, just the flick against my ball, like, it made my. I can't explain the pain to. I don't know. I've broken fingers, less painful. I've had kidney stones, less painful. I mean, obviously, kidney stones, the pain lasts a lot longer, but. If you had to say, Ronaldo, you're gonna have 10 minutes of ball pain because we're gonna like kick you in the balls, or you can have kidney stones for 2 days. I'll take kidney stones. Kidney stones, like no doubt, no doubt. You're gonna ask any man, would you rather have kidney stones for 2 days, or would you rather want to be kicked in the balls? No man will say that they want to be kicked in the balls. Actually, not even flicked. Well, it's a tough one. Carly Green says other people break your kneecaps. Well, I don't want other people to break my kneecaps. Oh, or I don't want to break my shin. This part. Have you seen those like horror movies where this breaks and then this part just dangles? And then the bone sticks out. Near me, fuck. To all the men that's watching this right now, I want you to comment quick. Would you rather have kidney stones or let's call it a ball ache? Which would you rather have? Kidney stones or a ball ache? When I say ball ache, I mean kicked in the balls. Do a poll. No, but if I do a poll, then you know the women are gonna say, oh no, man, a kick in the balls. I want the men. Shin splits. Check. Oof, and now that's also sore. Nicholas says I would rather have none of those. Well, you know what? Also, I have none of any super chats. I mean, guys, I get it's middle of the month, but I mean, yo, can I at least get like a 7 rand for some electricity? You know? I mean, I'm running my generator outside to do the stream. I mean, I worked out running my generator, and this is actually not bad. I'm not gonna lie. Running, because so. For let me, what is the petrol price at the moment here? Sorry, my nose is itching. I don't have a drug problem, I promise you. I'm just my nose is because I've got like the this gets into the nose and then it itches. Let's call it 19 rand times 14. No, man. Petrol's a lot more expensive than 19 Rand. How much is the petrol now? Is it 21 Rand? 21 times 14, because that's how many liters, divided by 10 equals. So for me to run the generator for 2 hours cost me 30 Rand. That's well worth it. Why, Zulu says, would you rather give birth? Well, I wouldn't know. Well, I would kind of know what that pain feels like, because nurses that have given birth and nurses that have had kidney stones says kidney stones are more painful. Now, remember, women don't have a urethra, right? They don't have a urethra where that stone has to pass through. Just putting it out there. So, I've had things that have been more painful than giving birth. Just gonna, and it's not me, it's not a man saying it, it's nurses. Because what do you think the hot topic was when I was in the hospital? The hot topic was, is it more painful to have kidney stones or to give birth? And all the nurses that have had kidney stones said kidney stones. Alfred Want gave a super chat. Wow, look at that. Thank you for the super chat, Alfred Want. 35 Rand saying, Ronaldo, ek het nog niks gebreek nie behalwe my hart. Hy was al gebreek as dit tel. Dis maar eina. Ek gaan nie jok nie. Okay, so let me put you in the kak now. Wie het jou hart gebreek, Alfroan? Onthou, jy is getroud, nee? Wie het jou hartjie gebreek, Alfroan? Sê vir ons almal so dat ons kan luister, wie het jou hart gebreek? En ek hoop jou vrou kyk ook. Carly Green says, I call bullshit, lol, when you tear. Oh, okay. Overshare. That's too much. Women do have a urethra. Okay. Yes. But not where a man has a urethra. Like if you had to take a penis and you had to bloop, then that is it. I have had kidney stones and I hardly felt it. When it passed, it sounded like a marble hitting the toilet.
Well, iemand het 'n groot een hierso. Ja, my urethra en penis is so groot. Daai ding het net ting 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 in die bad in die bad in die toilet geval. Hy het sommer die raam van die toilet gekraak ha, in sy moer. Ting ting ting. Hy kidney stone was 2 cm groot. Groot my urethra en ballas en dinges. Jacques Hubert gave a 14 Rand super chat. Thank you very much, Jacques. It's greatly appreciated. And then Debbie Murray gave 140 Rand. Wow. Debbie is very generous lately. Debbie, you don't have to give a super chat whenever I ask for it. You know that, right? You definitely have contributed considerably. And I really do appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you for the 140 Rand. And she says, the popcorn and movie for tonight's movie marathon. Thank you. Thank you very much. I really do appreciate it. Thank you to all of you. Thank you, Alfrawan, Jock, and Debbie. And to everybody that smashed the like button. There is 5 minutes left, so I'll do 2 more minutes because I have to switch over. Yes, watch out for Living Life. Do we still talk about that guy? And it's Loving Life, yeah. He corrected himself. I don't know. Is he still relevant? Does he have more than 10 people visiting his website? Or is it just bots? A vascular dislocation of the right femur. 7 hours waiting for rescue. Wish to die. Pluck some. This is your femur, right? Your femur. Is this your femur? Your hip bone. Is that your femur? Or is it this? Is it this bone here on the top of your leg? About 20 members now on LL. Wow. Record breaking. Oh, it's your Bobian. Ooh. That, ooh. Because, like, the thing is, when it breaks, it immediately penetrates the muscle. And then that fragments of bone is stuck in your muscle. Okay, this is... Alright, look, this is... Look at that. Hey, yay! And then, yeah, nee, yay, nee, yay. Yay, lung show. Look at that. This was 15,000 Rand to get it to look like that.
Thank you to the specialist that fucked up my finger even more. Thank you. Thank you for putting the pin, like he put a pin in about that deep. And he gave me the exercise. Look, I can't even close my fist. Can't, like, if I do that, and it still hurts. In the winter, like, look at the size of my knuckle. Look at that. Like, just for comparative purposes, look at this, look at that, and then look at that one, right? Now, I know I don't have the most beautiful hands. Like, I mean, my left hand doesn't look bad, you know? It's like, hi, yes, look at that. Mm. And it's like, my gebrekkelijke handjie. Take my strong finger. That looks like arthritis. This is a cricket ball on the tip. And then five people that think they're doctors on the sideline that all try and dislocate it, when in actual fact it's broken. And the nerve at the top, I mean, I can't, this is the only way I can straighten it. Like, I can't actually, you know, like with your fingers you can do that. Now look at this. Like, okay, do it, Ronaldo. Whoop. Do it, Ronaldo. 16,000 rand. Couldn't fix it. After promising me, oh, it'll be like new. It'll be like new. Cock story. Jock, thanks again for another 14 rand. I really appreciate it. Thank you. You're very generous, Jockey. What is your profile pic, by the way? Let me just look here. Oh, okay. Lekker. Is that a pipe in die mond? Or am I... I can't really see. Is it a... I love the hat. And I like a pipe in die moinkie as a draag is. It's either a pipe or it's iets anders. Kom ons hoop maar is a pipe. If we lose a pinky, are we disabled? No. No. If you lose a thumb, I would say, then you could be considered disabled. Watch the time. Oh, shit. Okay, thank you for that. Everybody, thank you so much for tuning in. Greatly appreciate it. Carly says, Freddy Krueger hiding under your bed, cutting your Achilles tendon. That's why there's no space under my bed, lol. Wasn't that Pet Sematary? Aren't you confusing Pet Sematary with Nightmare on Elm Street? Or it could have been in one of those. Anyway, I have to go. Ah, call me dispatch, no 8. Thanks so much for tuning in, everybody. It's greatly appreciated. Shit. Babes, I need to tell you, they said it could be like a... What is the word for a heat rash? What did somebody in the comments say? Sorry, I forgot about it now. They said that we just need to check out for... And I'm not like... You know, we can Google it. I'm not going to blindly believe them, but somebody has said that Bostons are quite well known for having, like, sort of not a heat stroke, but it's like, somebody will tell me, eczema. There we go. Could be eczema. I wish our, you know, like, we didn't have to pay all that money for the fucking vet. We could have just asked. Yeah. Thank you, everybody. And I can't remember who originally said it, but thank you. And Lauren says, thanks, we'll check it out. Alright, thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you all tomorrow night at 7 p.m. for Attack Chat. Have a lucky evening. I might be on TikTok a little bit later, just to, you know, keep the momentum going. But I don't know when. I don't know exactly what time and even if I'm going to do it. Debbie says, eczema and dear, what's it? I can't say this word. Homeopath. She said homeopath can resolve. Homeopath. Sorry. I'm sorry. I can't pronounce that word. That is like my kryptonite, that word. All right. Thank you all for tuning in. Homepath. That's what it says. Oh, thank you. No, Wadzulu got it wrong. She deleted it. Ha ha. The walking talking dictionary got it wrong. Ha 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 ha. Lahooser, Wadzulu got it wrong. She said home path. That's clearly wrong. Mm-mm. Not the walking talking dictionary anymore. Sorry. All right. Have a lekker one, everybody. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll catch you all tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Till later. Cheers and peace out.
You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say, I wear my massacre. You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say, I wear my massacre. I wear my massacre. You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say, I wear my massacre.